Welcome to MusicMoveIt.com. I am Torio. Today we're going to talk about how to make sure you're not getting scammed by so-called music promoters. So you have a new album coming out or a new single coming out and you're looking for ways to promote. Now, of course, you want to do what you can and spend as little money as possible because most indie artists are on some kind of a budget, which is fine. But you just got to make sure these people that you're working with are legit. There are people that offer likes and views to your YouTube videos and likes on your Instagram or your Twitter or your Facebook. And that right there, yes, it may inflate your numbers and inflate your views, but you're not gaining anything by getting these fake views and fake followers. For one, most of them use bots. They're fake bots. Basically what they do, they create a bunch of fake accounts on YouTube or Instagram or whatever, and then they write a script, and these bots go out and all these they have all these fake accounts like your page. And or they view the YouTube video through different proxies and things like that. Now it inflates the numbers, yes, but if it's fake bots, it's not real people. These bots aren't gonna download your music. Even if it's a view on YouTube, it's not gonna translate to a bot liking your song. Like, oh, I gotta listen on Spotify, and or I'm gonna support the artist and go to a show when they come to town or whatever. It's fake bullshit. And you don't need that. You shouldn't really inflate your numbers. Plus, a lot of sites are cracking down on this now. And if they detect this stuff on your account, they will take your music video down. They will delete all the followers, or they'll, you know, there's tons of methods now that they're trying to use to detect these fake likes and fake views. So I would steer clear of all that and not even do anything like that. You got to work to get these followers. You got to work to get these views and listeners. And that way you get real people to actually buy your music in the future or go to your show in the future to support you and possibly buy merch or whatever you may offer. You want strong, true fans and loyalty. Another thing is email blasts. A lot of companies will say, oh, we'll take your song and we'll blast it in an email, a link to your song in an email or your YouTube video to thousands of DJs and things like that. Now, some of these services are legit, and the best thing to do for this is to ask for references. I mean, you're spending money. Some of these services are expensive as hell. I've seen some services are like $500 to $1,000 for a huge email blast to 20,000 DJs and things like that. Now, to make sure it's legit, I would ask for references. A good company is always more than happy to show you, we've worked with this artist. You can even contact the artist because they know they did a good job and they know they're not going to get bad feedback, or they're not going to have an artist come back and say, hey, it was all fake bullshit. So if it's a good company, they have no problem giving you some kind of references. So, and also, if it's a website, if the person has a website and they're offering an email blast, you can check how long they've been around as a company. You can do a search on Google and you can get website stats to see exactly when the site started. So if this company started like 6 months ago, I don't know. I mean, you got to question these things. Kind of be like a detective in a way. But you want to make sure you're not getting scammed out of your money. Years ago, when I was trying to put out music, when I was just beginning almost, there was an offer I paid for and they said, we'll send your press release of your music to all these publications and newspapers and all this stuff. I paid it and got absolutely nothing out of it. I can't remember how much it was, but it was such a friggin' letdown. It was like supposedly like 20,000 to 30,000 different newspapers and online magazines and online bloggers, and nothing came out of it. Absolutely nothing. And that's a lot to, you know, send out to. At least someone would have bit and be like, hey, I want to write a story on you, or I want to mention your CD in this. But it just was all bullshit. And come to find out, other people got scammed through the same person as well. There was a whole forum about this website, and eventually it got shut down. Now, another thing is paying to be on shows, paying to open for a major label artist. Now, I've seen so many people get burnt by this too. For many years, I've seen it, and people get so mad. Like, they'll want something like, I've seen people want $500,000 to get a good spot as an opening act on a major label artist concert. And it was a fly-by-night company that didn't even intend to do anything for any artists. Bullshit promoter. They took the money and skipped. And then, of course, the artists get to the show and they're like, we already have opening acts. And they're just completely screwed out of the money. And they're not one of the opening acts. You got to watch that stuff. A way to see if they're legit or not, again, ask for references. See if they have a good website that's been around for a while, maybe. See if this, ask around. See if this promoter has been around for a while. Google the name. Google the promotion company if you have to. There are some legit things like this where people have paid for a good spot for a major show. It's up to you if you think it's worth it, if you think opening for this artist is worth it, the fan base of them and things like that, but be careful. Also, anything someone saying, I could get you a record deal, it's most likely BS. I mean, you just can't trust things like this. And legit people who are looking to help artists generally will not ask for huge amounts of money up front. They just won't. Just, you know, think about it. It's usually always on the back end or a percentage on the back end if they want to take you under their wing to try to get you published through a publishing company or signed to a deal. So be smart about that. And also, they won't work with just anybody. So if it seems like they're take any artist in and work with them and they're wanting thousands of dollars, it's probably bullshit. Now, like I said already, there are services that do work and have done good things, decent, honest promotion for artists. And you just gotta see. Like, I've done things in the past where I wanted more exposure for maybe a song I was working on or something. And I knew someone who had a huge Twitter account with tons of followers that were music listeners, basically, because this person already established these Twitter followers because maybe he has like a radio, internet radio station or some kind of podcast that deals with music, and legit music listeners were listening to it. So he had a large Twitter account with all these people that like new music. So I paid a small fee. It wasn't nothing big. That's another thing. Most honest services aren't going to charge you thousands of dollars unless they have a huge reach or something like that. But I paid like once, I think it was like $100, and this guy had like 40,000-50,000 Twitter followers, and I felt the effects of it. I got people to listen to the song. People emailed me. People left comments about the song, and it was legit comments with real people, real email addresses and things like that. So you just got to watch. You got to see. Are they legit? Will they work for you because of what they do? Can they help you out? Another thing I once did was I did an email blast, but it was through a company that was straight up legit. I'm not going to name the companies on that and all that, but it was a legit company that dealt with music. They've been around for years and they already had an established email list, and it worked out perfectly. I paid a decent fee and they sent out my song in a newsletter to all these people that signed up to their service already, and I got great feedback, like thousands of people giving me feedback on my music. You really just got to use your brain and see what does their website look like, who has this person worked with in the past and things like that, and that's it. It's common sense. So please don't get scammed by these fake music promoters that promise you all these things and they don't come through, or they use bots or whatever. Stay away from it all. So now, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you haven't. Hit that bell icon next to the subscribe button so you can get notified of new videos. I need some ideas. What do you want to talk about next? What do you want to know about next as far as music business and things like that? Leave it in the comments. Also, if you've experienced a great service that did things for you and you paid a decent amount of money, let us know. Let us know about the service. Or have you been scammed in the past by some bullshit, some fake stuff? Let us know that as well. Look down in the description area. There are tons of resources to help your music career down below. A lot of links. Check it out. They're legit. And I promise you there's something there that can help your career. So check it out.
And I will see you next video. Thank you.